Hello smart dropshippers, if you are aware of my previous video, I have talked about 4 different tools provided by Google which are free, called Google Trends, Market Finder, Shopping Insights and Keyword Planner, which we can use to market research before launching our product. So in this video, I will give you the tutorials of these tools in brief. And for this purpose, I have chosen a micro niche which is called gimbal or camera stabilizer. I will show you a live website as an example of a gimbal shop that's called Evo Gimbal, which sells smartphone gimbals, DSLR gimbals and GoPro or action camera gimbals online. We will build a niche or micro niche shop which will sell only gimbals from different brands later in another video. So to do this, we have to research on the market, and that's why I am showing you this example. So let's start with Google Trends. Google Trends is a website by Google that analyzes the popularity of top search queries in Google search across various regions and languages. The website uses graphs to compare the search volume of different queries over time. To open Google Trends, you have to type inside Google, that's Google Trends, and it will take you to this website trends.google.com/trends. Here you can search any type of search term or keyword. Like for this example, I am showing you the search query or search volume of gimbal. Here we can see the search volume graph is horizontal, almost horizontal, so demand is very similar over time. You can search it worldwide to check the search volume, search interest over time, and also you can see the past 5 years report. And if you look closely, you can see over the 5 years the search query is gaining interest over time, and this is a trending product, you can say. To simplify this process, I have searched different types of keyword using this Google Trends, like buy gimbal, camera stabilizer, gimbal stabilizer, smartphone stabilizer, etc. And you can see the query for gimbal is very high and gimbal stabilizer is also high. So this is how you can test the Google Trends to check the different keywords and their global search interests. And you can see there are different countries like Canada, India, United States, United Kingdom and Philippines. These countries mostly want to check about the gimbal or camera stabilizer. And you can say with this report that these are the demanding countries for your product. Also, you can check the details yourself and you will understand better. This is how Google Trends works. Now, we will talk about Market Finder, another tool provided by the Think with Google project, and we will use it to research our potential market. Market Finder is a free platform provided by Google which helps you expand your business into international markets. Market Finder is divided into three categories like researching, operation planning, and marketing. We will see the details of these categories inside Market Finder tool. To open Market Finder, you just have to type inside Google Market Finder Think with Google. And this website will come up, marketfinder.thinkwithgoogle.com. Just click on it, and here comes the Market Finder site. As we don't have any website ready to check, I will use the previous example of Evo Gimbal to check the different markets inside this tool. So I am copying this website link and entering this inside this box and click on this arrow. It will pull all the product categories from this website and give you the suggestion markets. Now you can see it suggests United States, Italy, Germany, and more if I log in to this tool. And you can see the monthly searches across different categories is nearly 27 million. And if you are going for Google Ads, you can see the recommended bid here. And this number is showing how easy is to do business in this country. Also, they are showing the household net disposable income of United States people. Also, Google Market Finder suggests you to sell this product in Italy and Germany. And you can see if you go for Google Ads, you can have very little bids for this type of product keywords. So I am going in and using my name and account. Also, you have to select your domestic market. I am selecting United States here, and yes, I want to stay updated. Tick on this checkbox and click on next. You can see more details from here. I am allowing my email address to use this, and here you go. Also, I can see India is also suggested by this Market Finder, and as previous Italy and Germany, Japan, and also United Kingdom. If you click on show more, you can see different countries suggested by this tool. And as a dropshipper, I would like to sell this gimbal to these countries only. And from here, you can select only three market or countries. I am adding United Kingdom, Australia, and Canada from here. And also, I have added United States as my domestic country. So here my profile is ready. I have to continue to the resources. And from here you can see they suggesting me to plan my operations. And these are the operational areas. That is localization, global payments, customer care, logistics, talent recruitment, tax and legal. As a dropshipper, you can see all these options, and I would like you to check this localization option a little bit. From here you can see their suggested video, and you can read some articles. And for languages, they are suggesting that all these three countries has English as their primary language, and also French, traditional Chinese, and French. if you select different countries, it will show you different languages according to that country. And if you are planning to sell in like Italy, Germany, you have to make your website multi-language capable. And for this, you can see their introductory localization course. You can check their Google course and you can use Google Translate in your website. So I would like to show you another thing about payments. Just click on Global Payments from Plan Your Operations submenu. Here you can see the forms of payment of different countries used most. And Google is suggesting that you might take card payment and e-wallet payment in these countries. Different countries prefer different type of payment method, and this tool shows you these details accordingly. And if you click on card and e-wallet and click see providers, you can see a list of providers like Aiden, Braintree, Ingenico, Stripe, Wirecard, WorldPay, PayPal, Vesta, etc. in your list as a payment processor or payment provider. Usually we will select the PayPal, and you can go directly to PayPal website from here. Also, if you have planned to use Stripe or Braintree payment gateway, you can check the availability of different countries from here. And if you go for logistics, you can see there are different providers which will provide you warehousing, last mile parcel and air parcel. These are for big businesses like wholesale and distributorship or import export, but we will stick with this last mile parcel and air. And you can see there are different courier partners like DHL, UPS, FedEx, etc. And they support all these countries. If you select different countries, you will get different service, logistic service providers here. So this is the Market Finder tool by Google, and there are more options you can check with. You can plan your marketing from here, and that's it. Initially, this information will help us to research about our potential market. Now it's time for the third tool called Shopping Insights by Google. This tool is also a part of Think with Google project, and you know Google is the first place shoppers go to discover a new brand or product. Shopping Insights helps you understand what they are looking for in your category. You have to provide which product and categories matter to you, and Google Shopping Insights will show you all the relevant trends with even more data as email in your inbox every week if you subscribe to their email service. So let's check out the Shopping Insights. To open Shopping Insights, just open the Google and type Shopping Think with Google or Shopping Insights Think with Google, and you will have this website shopping.thinkwithgoogle.com. Just click on this site and here you are. And inside this box, search box, you have to type the product name. And as per our previous example, I am giving you the insights of Evo Gimbal in this Shopping Insights tool. And you can see the searches over the time, but It is from June 12 to July 12, 2019, and you can change it to last 1 year. And you can see the search volume is a little declining, but it's okay. This is for their product only. And you can see the interest by location and search volume by location from here in United States. And please keep in mind, this tool is only available for United States currently, and Google is working on to release on another countries very soon. Also, you can check the mobile and desktop search volumes and also the both search volumes of this product. And also you can add a category of products to see which brands are your potential competitors. So I am entering camera stabilizers and supports here inside this tool, and it's checking for top brands. Now you can see the GoPro, DJI and other brands produces products in this category. So you can check this GoPro from here also, and I would suggest you to check the every details of this site to know this tool better and to know about your competitors. The last tool in our Google free tools arsenal is called Google Keyword Planner. And Keyword Planner is a free Google Ads tool for new or experienced advertisers. That's like a workshop for building new search network campaigns. And also you can use Keyword Planner to search for keywords and see how a lead of keywords might perform in search queries. So basically we will use this Keyword Planner tool to know about different keywords and combinations of our product, and it will also help us for our market research. To use Keyword Planner, you have to search Keyword Planner inside Google, and you can skip the first advertisement and directly jump on to this tool, ads.google.com Keyword Planner. Remember, you have to log in with your Gmail account to use this tool. You cannot use this tool without logging in. So I am going to sign in and skipping this information, hiding this information from you. So after logging in, you will be redirected to this Keyword Planner tool, where you can check about any website or about a bunch of keywords to discover new keywords, or you can get the search volume and forecasts from here. Now I am going to click on discover new keywords. Here I will put the previous examples, Evo gimbal website URL, and it will show you all the keywords related to this website. So just type in evogimbals.com. Entire site, get started, and now you can see the average monthly searches from here. But before going into the details, you have to set the location from here, and here it is United States, the whole country. Save. Also you can search for different countries. I am going to take some keywords inside this tool like gimbal, and here you can see the average monthly search volume is 10k to 100k and competition is very high, and this is the bids. Also you can see the related keywords from here. You can drag it a little bit and there are more results. So basically you can use these tools to get an idea of the search volumes and their competition level, and in this way this tool will help you to get some overview of different markets. You can see like Australia, where we have planned to sell this, and also gimbal is searched 1k to 10k and competition is also high, but bid is very low. Now you have understood these tools effectively and you now have learned how to research for your potential markets beforehand launching your dropshipping business or any kind of startup. So I would suggest you to take notes from this video and use your own brain to find and explore these tools to use it for later stages in your business. If you have liked this video, please hit on the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe my channel Smart Dropshippers for the latest and new technology videos about dropshipping as a whole.